Hey, welcome to Trinity Kids. My name is Jared. I'm so excited that you're here. We've got some great stuff in store for you, so let's get going.
How does your favorite story end? Wait, first, how does your favorite story begin?
In a world where a kid who has something to learn, something to discover.
This kid finds unexpected friends. They head out on an adventure and face some tough challenges. Then when things are the darkest, when all hope seems lost, something, someone comes through to save the day. And everyone celebrates! Now, think about this. We are hardwired to love stories because each one of us is living one. We're all human and we all make mistakes. But sometimes the road ahead can be so rough, we don't know how to fix the problems we face. But we do know the times we've seen God at work. We know He sent a hero right into the middle of our story, God's own son, Jesus. And we know that when we follow Jesus, God promised an ending more incredible than anything we can imagine. Wherever we go, He goes with us too. When we live out our story with hope and faith, others can see God at work in us. That's why faith is an amazing way to worship God with your life. Because worship is about more than just singing loud. It's all about living loud.
I was buried beneath my shame. Who could carry that kind of weight? It was my turn till I met You. I was breathing. All my failures I tried to hide. It was my turn, yeah. Till I made You call me.
Out of
I need a rescue. My sin is heavy, but chains break at the weight of your glory. I needed shelter, I was an orphan. Now you call me a citizen of heaven. Well, I was broken.
is a place for me. I'm a child of God. Yes, I am.
Are you trying to catch a fly with chopsticks blindfolded?
What does it look like I'm doing?
Wouldn't a fly swatter be easier?
It is said one who captures a fly with chopsticks can do anything.
Really?
Yeah.
Can I try?
sure.
All right.
Focus. 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 Focus.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that was easier. Welcome to the So and So Show
in 3D!
Whoa!
Whoa! Whoa! Whoa! Whoa! Yeah!
I'm Brandon!
And I'm John, and it's nice to meet you. Here, let's shake hands! Whoa!
Amazing ride! It's like you're practically here in the room with us!
Yeah, so you can join us in this Nerf Fight!
Yes!
Boom.
Woo!
Boom. Oh, mine doesn't work very
mine
well.
Mine either.
Yeah. Yeah, look at that. Oh!
I don't know the trick.
Oh, man.
Oh, wow.
I hope we didn't hit anyone.
You all can thank John for making this possible. He's the one that sent you the 3D glasses that you're wearing right now. Nerf fight again! Boom! 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 What happened? Are you out of
No, nothing,
darts?
Nothing. It's nothing. It's just nothing.
Oh, it's clearly something.
No, it's just that you know how I said I'd send 3D glasses to everyone who watches the show?
Yes.
I did not do that! Nerf fight! Yay!
John, stop it! Stop!
Okay.
Look, if they're not wearing the glasses, then it's not in 3D, and we're just throwing stuff at the camera.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I knew I should have asked Ron to send out the glasses.
Well, it's just that I was busy buying the ping pong balls and the Nerf darts, and I just wait. Ron? Who's Ron?
He's a new friend of mine. Anyway, today on our apparently two-dimensional version of the show.
No, wait. New friend?
What?
Your new friend? You said you had a new friend. Like who?
Yeah.
Who's Ron?
He's just a guy that I met. You'd like him, actually. You would. I mean, you guys are into a lot of the same things. You comic books, soccer, air drumming, food.
I do like food.
Yeah.
But I don't think I like this Ron fellow. I mean, what kind of name is Ron anyway, right? Straight letters. What's it short for? Rundiculous?
Ronald, I think.
That's Ron-diculous.
Look, I'm telling you, you'd like him. He even overreacts to little things like you do.
Overreacts? How dare you? That hurts, man. That really hurts.
Uh-huh. So maybe if you just got to know Ron, you would feel differently. I could introduce you.
Never. I don't like Ron. Mm-hmm. I don't. And I don't want to get to know him.
Come on. I could set up a meeting. It could be right here or at the comic book store down the street.
I will not meet Ron. Here or there.
Okay.
I will not meet Ron anywhere.
Would you meet Ron in a house?
I would not meet Ron in a house.
Would you meet Ron with a mouse?
I would not meet Ron in a house. I would not meet Ron with a mouse. I will not meet Ron here or there. I will not meet Ron anywhere.
How about in a box?
Not in a box or with a fox or on a train or in a tree. I will not meet Ron Brandon. Now please let me be. What?
Nothing. Nothing. Hey, listen, we're friends, right?
Well, what, you and me, or you and Ron?
Me and you, we're friends.
Yeah, I used to think so.
Well, we know we are, and you trust me, right? I mean, I've never given you any reason not to trust me.
No, I trust you.
All right, good. Then you can trust me when I say that Ron is a good guy, and you would really like him, okay?
What are you doing?
I'm texting Ron and telling him to come over.
No!
Yes,
no!
Yes, I am.
I'm doing it.
It's done. It's done. Huh. Oh, good. He's coming over now. You're gonna like Ron. Whatever. It's Bible story time with Kellen.
Hey, everybody. Who wants a slice of pizza? Reach out and take it.
Oh, we're not doing 3D anymore, Kellen.
Oh. Why not?
We forgot to send out the glasses.
Bet Ron wouldn't have forgotten.
Oh. Who's Ron?
Brandon's new best friend who never makes mistakes and does everything right all the
time. Do you have a Bible story for us, Kellen?
I do. It was going to be in 3D with lots of computer graphics and lasers and special effects, and we spent this year's budget making it. But since no one has 3D glasses, let's do some human head puppet theater! Today's story is about Paul.
Oh, I'm a lumberjack and I'm okay.
What? No, not Paul Bunyan. Paul the Apostle. The Paul who used to put people who believed in Jesus in jail until he saw Jesus and became one of Jesus' followers. That Paul.
Oh, yeah, that makes sense. Carry on.
When Paul became a believer in Jesus, he made it his mission to travel the world to tell people Jesus' story. That's why Paul was in Athens, Greece.
Oh, I'm in Athens, Greece for the whole day. I don't cut trees down, but that's okay. What is this unusual statue?
I am Zeus, the God of Thunder. See my lightning bolt? Shazam!
God of Thunder? Is that a thing?
Oh, sure, sure. Athens has all sorts of gods. God of Music, Goddess of Love, God of Responsible Dental Hygiene. We're everywhere! Shazam!
But there's only one true God. I am very upset.
Hey, don't insult me. Didn't I mention I got a lightning bolt? You're going down, mortal! Shazam!
It is true that Paul was upset when he saw all the statues built to honor other gods, but the statues, they didn't speak. They just kind of stood there.
Aw, man.
Better.
There are statues of gods everywhere. There's a god of woodworking, a god of the sea, and what's this? An altar? To an unknown god? I've got to talk to someone about this.
Shazam!
Shh.
Sorry.
Now, here's something that you should know about Athens when Paul was there around 2,000 years ago. Athens was full of smart thinkers and philosophers, but they weren't very familiar with the story of Jesus. So Paul had some work to do.
Excuse me.
Mm-hmm.
Are you from Athens?
Toga, toga, toga! Ah!
Yeah, okay. I just wanted to say, Jesus has risen from the dead.
Toga?
You know they would have said more than just toga.
It's the only Greek word I know.
Ah, okay. The people were confused by what Paul was telling them, so they took him to a meeting of the Areopagus, where some of the brightest, most powerful people in Athens would talk about the latest ideas.
People of Athens, I can see that you are very religious. I saw all the things you worship, even an altar to an unknown god.
Toga, toga, toga.
I'm going to tell you about this unknown god.
Toga?
He is the god who made the world and everything in it. He gives life to all people.
Toga? Toga.
It's true. You know how some of your poets have said, we are God's children?
Toga.
That's right. We are God's children. Mm-hmm. So we shouldn't think God is a statue made out of stone. God can raise a man from the dead.
The people of Athens listened. They liked to hear thoughts and ideas that challenged what they believed. But when they heard Paul talk about the dead being raised, well, some of them made fun of the idea.
Toga!
But some wanted to hear more.
Toga.
And some became followers of Jesus.
Toga! No, wait, I thought of another word. Euro!
The people of Athens may have never seen Jesus, but Paul was able to help them have faith in someone that they couldn't see. The end. Fun story, guys. Thanks for your help.
Thank you, Kellen.
Way better than that 3D story you had planned, right?
Sure.
Hey, Paul was awesome. He wanted anyone and everyone to know Jesus.
Right. He knew that if people got to know Jesus, their lives would be changed forever.
Yeah. And he always found different ways to share the good news of Jesus to different people. It was so important to him.
Hey, thank you so much, Kellen. You're an awesome 2D storyteller.
Good to know. See you guys next time.
Hey, say, listen, about this whole Ron situation, I think I understand.
Hold that thought. Come in, Ron.
I like him already. Reveal the question.
How can you help others know Jesus?
Thanks, man.
Mm-hmm. We all know it's important for people to know who Jesus is and what he's done for us. So what are some ways you can help people know Jesus's story?
You can tell them the story through Dr. Seussian rhyme.
That's hilarious.
Thanks. Yeah. You could also invite someone to church. That's a good answer. Or you could tell them about the show.
I was going to say the same thing.
You were?
Totally.
Get out. That's ridiculous.
Hey, you want to go out and get some food?
You bet. I love food.
All right. I'll meet you at a restaurant right after the show.
You bet. Hey, Ron, you're my new best friend.
You?
I told you you'd like him.
I would meet Ron with a mouse.
Alrighty. Hey, thanks for tuning in, folks. This was the So-and-So Show.
Bye. Hey, I'm coming, best friend. All right.
I like food.
Hey, thanks so much for joining us today. I hope you had an absolute blast. We hope you're having an amazing week, too, and that you're on your A game. We'll see you next week. Kapow!